Air was top scorer for the Mooremen last weekend, scoring 1-2. There are five changes to the Tyrone team. Justin McMahon and Ronan McNamee are selected in the full back line, with Ronan McNabb coming in at wing back. Emmett McKenna starts at wing forward, with Ronan O'Neill selected at full forward. Meath's Cormac Riley gets this replay underway after a slight delay due to the large crowds coming into Páirc Chesler. And it's down, hoping to get a good start to the match. Tyrone lucky to get out of jail last week as a long ball put in from Don O'Hare across towards his corner forward compatriot Conor Laverty. Picked up here now by Conor McGinn. Bit of space in front of McGinn and he's going through. Tries to hand pass the ball over the bar, but he's been blocked. And Cormac Riley points to the spot. It's a penalty for Down. Unbelievable. Well, there didn't seem to be much danger here as Peter Hart came across, but the decision is a penalty. A chance now for Aidan Carr, and it's been saved by Niall Morgan. Carr scored last week, but Michael O'Neill was in goal. Morgan denies him. Down looking to get the first score of the game. Aidan Carr again with a good ball inside, this time towards Conor Laverty. He's a dangerous player. Nice space bill for himself, and that's a wonderful score. Down take the lead through Conor Laverty. Kavanagh looking to get Tyrone moving. That's a nice diagonal pass towards Ronan O'Neill. Cuts inside Ryan Boyle. This is still O'Neill, and off his left foot puts over a fine point. The teams are level. Picked up by Peter Hart. This is a good run from the wing back, and it opens up in front for him. Still Peter Hart. There's a goal chance here, and the ball has gone over the crossbar. Fantastic run from Peter Hart. It was a goal on, you know. Tyrone really on top at this stage. Sean Kavanagh. Ball inside towards Kieran McGinley, and the ball has gone to the back of the net. And Tyrone now lead by 5 points. McKernan tried to track back, but McGinley scores. Well broken down again by Sean Kavanagh. Such an inspirational captain. Dragged to the ground. Free into Tyrone. They really are on top here in Newry, and he calls for Niall Morgan. Morgan was really missed by Tyrone when he had to leave the field last week. And there's another point from the goalkeeper. Down needs something really before the break. Under an awful lot of pressure here, but maybe this is a chance for them. Picked up though by Ronan McNamee. He's under pressure from Jerome Johnston. And the rain pouring down here in Newry. Conditions really treacherous underfoot. Very hard for anybody to get a firm footing. And that one has gone over from Conor Laverty, a second of the match. Down needed it. Down finishing the half well. Still needing a couple of points, you would feel, before the break. Long crossfield pass towards Dan Gordon. Conor Clark with him. Gordon, though, doing well. And still gets the return. Now, tight angle for Dan Gordon. Lots of height on that one. And it's gone over the bar. That's an inspirational score from Dan Gordon. So then, what can Down do here? Don O'Hare. And that's his third point of the match, and there's only two between them. So Tyrone rattled at the end of that first half. Down managing to score 4 points in a row. As this ball comes into Kieran McGinley. Oh, what a start to the second half for Tyrone, and for Kieran McGinley, his second goal of the match. Where was the marking? But great finish. Tyrone pressing high up the pitch, not letting Down come out with the ball at all. Now then, that's Brendan McVeigh, but that's a poor clearance really. And there's a chance here. Sean Kavanagh, must be a goal. Oh, comes down off the crossbar. Sean Kavanagh, so unlucky. He did everything right, turned inside. Wonderful strike, but off the bar. Conor Laverty into Benny Coulter, such an inspirational sub last week, and he's at it again. Great point from Benny Coulter. Down Cadoo with a few more scores now. They're trailing by 7. That's Johnston. Laverty trying to get the ball back to Johnston. Held up there, though, by Justin McMahon. And, well, the referee, Cormac Riley, had to make a decision, but was happy with it. Here it is again, as it was gathered by Johnston. He was definitely held by McMahon, but then he was released, and Johnston fell to the ground. Nice ball inside to Niall McKenna, the substitute, turning away from Daniel McCartan. And a pass across, oh, and the ball has gone wide. But the referee has signalled for a penalty, and that bemuses a lot of the Down players. Kevin McKernan, the judge, to have pushed Ronan McNabb. Peter Hart scored a goal from the spot last week, and does it again. And this game is really getting away from Down now. Good turn again from Sean Cavan, is such a strong player. Very good in possession, and that's a lovely pass as well into the chest of Niall McKenna. There's a point here for the taking, and McKenna does just that. Wonderful score. Here's Matty Donnelly. Long ball inside. Out comes the goalkeeper McVeigh to punch it clear. He's down, try and work the ball out, but that's a very poor one. Easily gathered. And here is Conor McCallisky, the substitute, and McCallisky fires it over. Lovely score. And Down really going into the qualifiers at this stage. Tyrone looking really good, and the referee, Cormac Riley, blows the full-time whistle. And it's Tyrone who are through to face Monaghan in the Ulster quarter-final. And a deserved victory of Tyrone, 3-11, Down 12 points.
We're disappointed. Felt we put in a decent performance, but obviously the scoreboard tells a different tale. You can see 3 goals, you're always going to be in trouble, but I didn't think it was a true reflection on the game. But look, that's the way it goes. We scored 4 points just before half time. Probably would have liked half time to go on for a little bit longer, and then fate would have it, the start of the second half they put the ball in the net. So look, it left us a huge mountain to climb, but huge credit to our guys. They felt they kept going whenever, you know, the tide was against them. They kept plugging away, but it wasn't to be.
And there you see, Tyrone will now take on defending champions Monaghan in the Ulster semi-final on June the 15th. Donegal will play Antrim or Fermanagh in their semi-final on June the 22nd. All right then. Owen Mulligan, when Tyrone failed to win at home, what was the mood amongst the Tyrone supporters ahead of this replay?
Yeah, Des, I remember walking out. I was at the match and I think they were in a state of shock from being such in a prominent position, 7 points up, to losing just 1 kick away from being out of the championship. But I think supporters questioned their defence and leaking goals, different things like that. I think Tyrone's been spoiled over the years with the likes of Philly Jordan, Ray McManaman, Conor Gormley, the late Conor McDonnell. Maybe it's time to give the young lads a bit of a break and, you know, try and nurse them into playing the championship and have a wee bit of patience.
Tyrone have been involved in several kind of high-profile redraws and replays. How does Mickey Hart set up for these replays?
Well, there's one manager that's very, very good about, you know, replays. I think he's only been beaten in 2 Ulster final, Armagh and Down in Newry in 2008. He'll find detail. He'll maybe watch the game, maybe high in the double figures, take, you know, the positives out of it and then take the negatives. Probably, you know, why the conceding goals, where's it coming from? Tackling, not tackling back. He'll key different men who changed the game, but he'll also highlight players that didn't give it. You know, bad tackles, not tracking your man, and it's not really nice when you're pinpointed. Mm-hmm. I'm sure the same as yourself.
Yeah, I'd agree with that. I mean, when you draw a game, you have a week, you're not going to be training hard, so there's a lot of time given to talking about it and what went wrong. I think Tyrone learned more. I think they focused in on where Down were strong the last day. Benny Coulter came in, for example, and he had a great game last day when he came in. And if you compare it to today, he didn't have the same influence. He touched the ball 5 times today, he touched the ball 15 times the last day. You know,
Let's have a look at how Tyrone tightened up.
Yeah, I think 3 things for me, really. They tightened up at the back. very much so. Here's a clip of where Down were strong last week. We had Kevin McCarron, who was brilliant last week, who didn't have the same effect today. That's down to Tyrone, no doubt. Conor Laverty had a great game the last day. He kicked 2 points today, to be fair to him. But he had a bit of space last week. This week, you see the ball going in. Tyrone had men back. Conor Laverty was there. You have four Tyrone men in the vicinity. They weren't going to give that space. Something when we used to play Tyrone, they would never cough up goals. In the league, they were coughing up goals. Last week, they wouldn't have been happy with it. And it's something they need to work on. I think Colm Kavanagh was influential here. He kept dropping back. You can see him. Laverty's through. He comes in with a tackle. Now, in fairness, he does give the free away. But that kind of passage through the middle was not there. It was something. Justin McMahon is another influence. You know, old heads, I suppose, a bit of experience. He breaks it down to himself here, comes out with it, and I think Tyrone, if they don't concede goals, would put it up to anybody, really. You know, you'd have to say it. And you have the options of Matty Donnelly, Peter Hart. This was a great score, won it around midfield, ran at the heart of the defence. He's a great fella to carry the ball. I think if they get the balance right, I think they'll get great confidence out of today.